Hello there from Delta Blues Tips. How are you all doing? I'm making a tentative attempt at starting to practice again after my latest bout of illness. And there's something I want to show you. I want to show you this. This is based on the model of a Martin, an old Martin. It's got like a long body. This hasn't been glossed, it's French polished. So I'm told. And this belongs to my new guitar tech. His name's John. And he's got a little local place here where I've moved to. This has got a great story, this. Now, John is a bit of a hands-on repairman. I'd say a master repair. And a long time ago, when he started out, this was the first guitar he built. Every single bit of this guitar has been built by hand. There's been no machinery used at all. All of it is by hand. And the reason I've got it here is because he wants me to play it for him. Now, he just threw this old, this is just an old set of machine heads he threw on that he had in the shop. He just put them on so he could put the strings on so I could test it. Isn't it a beautiful piece of work?
Look at it.
Let's have a listen to what it's like. So he's told me to take it home and keep it here and test it out. And I'm slowly messing around and playing with it. It's an interesting guitar. It's a guitar I'd love to own, I'll tell you. A lovely smell of it. So there you go. And I think he's considering he's going to start making these actually to sell. I'll find out what kind of price he's looking for when he makes them, and I will duly report back. So that's the small body guitar. The second one I want to show you is my guitar, my new guitar. except it's not new. It's a 1966 Gibson J50. Beat up as hell. That's it. There it is. Now, those of you who anoraks in this kind of thing will notice straight away that I think I'm right in saying that this Gibson sign should be black. And this also is a sticker. Because all this part here, this guitar has a lot of damage to it. This has all been gouged out, it's not straight across. I can run my finger and it's rippling right the way through. All through here. If you look at the back there, you'll see. You can see. Can you see the damage where it's all come away? It's come away right across the machine heads. Great big cracks through it. I don't know if you can see that. Can you see that in the light there? Right through here. All the way. And here. All the front is being sanded. And I can feel the waves in the wood. All over. Even where the scratch plate is, it lifts up here. So it's all waved there. It's full of cracks. I have to tell you, even with that sign on it, it's still a real Gibson. You can tell straight away. Get that bass. This is a beautiful guitar to play. It's one of the best I've ever played, actually. Stays in tune, Grace. Even though I'm messing with it, it does stay in tune, Grace. So there was an old guitar I had in a case that I had lying it, never used to play, and I took it in and swapped it, so it didn't cost me a penny, and I'm really chuffed. What it is, I just changed the strings before. I tried the D'Addario on it, 80-20 bronze. That was nice. And just as a test, I've now put 8020 Martin SPs on. And I don't know whether I like the Diodario better. I think it's because it's a Gibson. The Diodarios seem to have something. So I may change them again later. I'm just testing everything at the moment. So this is my new guitar, and I'm going to hope to be able to get some good sounds down when I get back into it. So I'm just saying I'm still around. Thanks to the people who've supported me while I've been ill and bought me discs and that, which has helped me out and allowed me to you know, carry on in this time when I haven't had a chance to make videos. But I've still been making the odd blog and that. Keep myself going and keep myself busy. By the way, the neck on this guitar is stunning, I have to say. It has got a truly stunning neck for playing. So as soon as I get myself together, which I hope now won't be too much longer, I'm going to be getting back into it again. And again, thanks for the support. So there you are, there's two really interesting guitars. One that's ended up as mine, and the other one, which was his first guitar he made. And I think it's a stunning guitar. And if I get the chance to own it, and if he'll sell it, he said he won't sell it. I'll have to try and get around him and see if he can do something, because I think it's a lovely guitar. So from Delta Blues Tips, and two interesting pieces of equipment. Here you go. My hands are already quivering holding them. I can't believe that he fashioned that neck purely by hand. It is stunning that someone could put all this together by hand. It takes a craftsman to do that. Anyway, hope you like that little look at these guitars. And hopefully now, it's not going to be too long, and I'll see you again, making some videos. Ciao for now, as they say, from Delta Blues Tips. Bye bye.